Okay, so this is the Fisher Price Learn with Me Zebra Walker. It's like, you know, baby can sit and play with it, or baby can, you know, walk, use it as to stand or walk. We're going to first start our daughter to use this to stand, and then later on use it as a walker. Okay, so I'm just going to show you how to assemble this first. So first thing is turn this around, and you will see two of this thing and eight of such screws, right? So what I've done is, if you look at the back side in this green, it should say left and right. So all you need to do is put the left one here, right one here, and connect it using these screws that they have provided. So there are eight of them. So you can see I have provided screw one here, screw two here, screw three here, and screw four here. So all the four screws are connected, right? And the screws are very tight to connect though. So make sure you understand that, you know, the screws will be super tight to connect. But once you connect the screws, just touch it, and it should not be like, you know, shaky. It should be very tight. And you will have to apply force to put this screws. I have to apply a lot of force. But you cannot make a mistake because the left one should say left and right one should say right. And simply, when you turn this backwards and you are facing it, it's your left and your right. So just the way you are facing it when it's turned backwards. Once you have connected this, next thing is this part. So I'm putting the four screws back for now. And you can see this thing here. Obviously, you can see this is the designer part that goes outside, right? So this is the part that will go on the front. So just look at this, how I'm doing it. Let me face it here like this. If it is placed like this, this part, right? Not the one with the screws, right? The one with the screws should be at the bottom. So you want to just connect it like this. And that's it. The second part is ready. Okay, so now this part is again easy. Just snap the wheels. Right? Now see this fancy part, this nice designer part should be on the outside and this should be on the inside. The main circular one. So it's very easy. Wheel number 3 and wheel number 4. We are almost done. Now comes the final part. Right? Where you need to basically connect this to this. So you can see the way I am doing it, right? Hold both of this like this. Right? This should be in the front and this should be at the bottom. So imagine this is in the front, right? And baby is holding the way I'm holding it, like, you know, you would hold a shopping cart. And just turn this around slightly. And let me show you here. So you can see this is in the front. And this is like a shopping cart. Put it in here. Like this. And it should just click in each other, right? Now when I turn it around, this is how it looks. And there are four holes. So I'm going to use the four screws that are provided to connect them. Right? You could have also done it like this. Which is, you know, keep it like this. And this thing just enters from the top. This is another easy way actually. This is much more easier compared to the manual way. Right? Now, you just need to put the four screws in the four hole and connect them. And that's it. It is ready. Also, this is the battery compartment here. If you want to play music and stuff like that. And you can see it has two AA 1.5 volt batteries, like normal batteries. Two of them, normal size batteries. So that way, you know, it can play music and stuff like that. Now I'm going to connect the screws and show you. Okay, so I put the four screws in, I put the batteries in and locked it back. Now I'm going to turn it on. So there is like a switch here for medium volume and high volume. I'm going to put it in high volume. I turn it on and this is how it starts. And now you see, when my daughter will move, which I'm going to show you, it will make noise, you can see. Because as soon as the baby starts walking, it starts to make noise saying that here we go. And right? And you can also do this. So these are all the buttons that you can see, right? Now I'm going to show you with my daughter. Okay, so she is 8 months old and you can see she is currently standing on her own legs and, like, you know, just playing with this thing. She's moving this thing. This thing obviously makes sound and I can leave her a little bit, but she's still learning to stand up. I'm not really going to walk her right now. I just want her to get used to holding something and standing up, right? And I don't want to put too much pressure on her as well. So I won't let her continuously stand on her own feet for a long time, but I want her to have some form of habit and control, right? So which is why I'm just leaving it a little bit. And because she's moving it a little bit, this thing is making noise. Now, and you can see she's like tightly holding this thing because she likes it. And now, another option is obviously, she can just sit and play with this thing, right? And you see, she's obviously playing and touching this thing. So it doesn't have to just be, like, you know, a standing touch. You can also use it to play. And now you can see this is a really, really nice way for her to play, to be close to this thing as well. Okay. Now. And you see, you need to let them explore a little bit, but then because I'm speaking, she's also interested in what I'm seeing. She's really interested when I speak. But you can see there are a lot of different options here, obviously, that she can play with it. And obviously, its main function is a walker though. So we are using her to stand up and then she will also move this thing. Once her feet become stronger, she can use this. So really, really nice and great toy, very easy to build as I showed you. And it's very nice and fat, it's not too heavy. So basically I can lift her with one hand and lift this with the other hand. I have done that and it's super simple to use. So I definitely recommend it to, you know, people. Okay, so this is obviously from infant to toddler, but you know, it's up to you how long you want to use it. It's 6 months plus, so once she's 6 months, you can start using this thing just to sit and play. Or when she's 8 months old and she likes to, she can easily stand and hold things for some time. So that's what we are going to use this for. So you know, she can have some standing time with this toy. So you can see what I'm doing now. You can see she does want to hold it because she knows that she can hold this thing. You obviously, initially when you want to stand, you might want to help her a little bit and not allow her to put too much pressure. So you see, I was holding her with one hand. But yeah, you know, I can leave her for a second. Let me make her hand legs straight. I want her to put her feet firmly and then I can leave her for a second. And you can see, she's pulling this thing herself a little bit. Yeah, all right. It's a great, great tool and great toy as well. Thank you.